In this video, we'll discuss what it means for a norm to be convex and how this property leads to unique best approximations. If you've encountered the concept of a norm before, it's likely you've seen a diagram similar to this. These plots show points or vectors about the origin for which the norm of these points are all the same, they're equal to 1, and we see different shapes for different LP norms. But why is this so important that it's shown in almost every lecture about norms? Answering this question also gives a good reason why we only use LP norms where P is greater than or equal to 1, and not, for example, an L1/2 norm. We have a point F inside a normed linear space capital B, and for any given norm we can visualize the points within a certain distance D away from F. For the L2 norm, that would be any point within this circle of radius D, the circle being made up of all the points B in capital B where the norm of B minus F is equal to D. Take any two points, B1 and B2, in the interior of this circle, and we can see that any points along the line connecting them are also in the circle. Any set which has this property is convex, and so we say the L2 norm is convex. For a full description of convex sets, click the link to the video. We can now appreciate an important point of this diagram is to show that the LP norm is convex for P greater than or equal to 1, since any two points within the interior of any of them will be connected by a straight line also within the interior. We can also see that for P less than 1, such as our earlier example of P equals a half, the norm is not convex. What is it about convexity that is so crucial that it's almost a requirement? Well, let's say we have a convex subset capital A of a normed linear space capital B from which we want to find the best approximation to F, a point in capital B. The best approximation is a point A star in capital A which minimizes the norm of A minus F. In other words, the closest point in capital A to F. Because the norm and capital A are convex, they meet at a single point A star, giving a single, unique, best approximation. If the norm is not convex, there may be two or more points equidistant from F, and therefore more than one best approximation. We're now ready to write down a uniqueness theorem for best approximations. If capital A is a convex subset of a normed linear space capital B whose norm is strictly convex, then for every F in capital B there exists a unique best approximation A star in capital A to F. If a set is strictly convex, the line connecting any two points is entirely in the interior of the set, not on the boundary, and that LP norms for P greater than 1 are strictly convex. Proving this theorem by contradiction is actually pretty simple. Let's assume the contrary is true and that there are two best approximations, A1 star and A2 star. By definition, they must both be the same distance from F, and we'll call this distance H star. Consider the point P halfway between A1 star and A2 star. Since it's on a line connecting A1 star and A2 star and capital A is convex, this implies that P is in capital A, and so P is also a valid approximation to F. But here is the crucial part of the proof. Since P is on a line connecting A1 star and A2 star, then also by the strict convexity of the norm, it must also be less than H star away from F. And so A1 star and A2 star are no longer the best approximations. This contradiction proves the theorem. So far, we've been working with abstract notions of best approximations. But this theorem has profound implications in a number of practical applications. Let's have a look at one. You're given a continuous function f over an interval from A to B and asked to approximate it using polynomials with the L2 norm. In a previous video, we showed that polynomials up to degree n form a convex set. We also know that the L2 norm is strictly convex, and so the theorem applies here. What the theorem implies is that for the set of polynomials of a given degree n, there will be one and only one polynomial that best approximates our function. Increasing n will increase the complexity of the polynomial and give us a better approximation, but for any particular degree of polynomial, there will still be a set of parameters c0 to cn which give the unique best approximation to f.